Hi, in this lesson, we are going to create our picture component in a Storybook. Let's do it. So the first thing that I'm going to do is go into Stories and there create a new folder called Picture. Then I'm going to create a similar structure as with the car. We are going to create picture.js. Then we are going to create index.js. And then we are going to create picture.module.css. And of course, we are going to create picture.stories.js. I'm not going to create any constant because this is not the case for this component. So for the index, remember that we are going to export the default value from picture. This is a concept that we have seen before called barrels. Barrels file, where basically we want to export just the folder is going to use by default the index.js files that at the same time is exporting the default component from picture. Let's create our picture. So in this case, it is going to be picture. I'm just going to export this. This is for the future in case I want to create a different test. The picture is going to receive a few different props because we are going to use our higher order component function. It's going to use the get styles that we've implemented before. It's going to receive a source to load the picture. It's going to receive a width as a mandatory prop because it's important to define what is going to be the width size of our pictures. And then it's going to receive a height that is going to be optional. And then I'm just going to receive a new prop. It's called is rounded in case I want to show my picture as rounded. And this is just going to return the classic picture HTML tag, but of course it's going to have a few things, like for instance the class names. So it's going to call the get styles, and then it's going to receive picture as a base class, and then in my case it's going to receive the is rounded option. So in that way, I can toggle this style from the module. And inside the picture is going to have an image tag, and the image tag is going to receive the source. And you are wondering, hey Guillermo, why are you using picture with the image tag? And it has a reason to be. What I'm going to do is show the picture as responsive as we can with the proper resolution. I'm going to set that the picture is going to have 100% width, and then the image is going to have a defined width. Of course, if you want to do it in this way, it's up to you. You can use any strategy or any structure that you want. So here it is going to receive the height style and a mask width, and this is what is the trick, is going to receive the width. So we are going to make sure that this grow as much as possible with the 100% width, but then I'm going to define a mask width as my strategy to set the proper width. So with that, we basically have everything. Now I'm just going to define the prototypes. Remember, this is a way to add types, but of course, if you use something like TypeScript, you don't need this. The source is going to be required. And I'm just going to import prototypes here so I can have my autocomplete. So remember, prototypes comes from this library called prototype. Then I'm just going to set the rest of the props. So the get styles is a function and also is required because it's the only way that I will get my styles. And then the width is going to be a number, and this is going to be required, but the height is completely optional. We will see in a minute why it can be optional, because we are going to define a default value. And then it's rounded is going to be just a boolean. So here in the default props, the high is going to be auto, and the get styles is going to be an empty function, so I don't get any error when we try to evaluate this without the hook. And finally, I'm just going to export by default with the styles, and this is the hook that we did before. And we pass the styles, we pass the picture. And of course, I need the CSS modules. So here we are going to import with the styles, and this should come from the hook. And here we have the with the styles. And then the styles, they are going to come from our picture module.css. So we should have everything correct here. And then let's just go to the modules. If we go here to the CSS modules, it's going to be pretty simple. So for the picture class with the image, we are going to set a display block, and then the width is going to be 100%. As I said, it's going to grow, but then I'm going to restrict that width with an inline styles. Take into account that what we are doing here is just for the image, we are saying a mask width. And the width is a required prop. Here is rounded class for the image. What we are going to set is the border radius is going to be 100%. So in that way, it can look like a circle when I need it. And now the fun part, let's write the stories, because now I have built my component. Usually it's much better, and that's a strategy that you can decide. Maybe write the stories first and then create the component, or do the thing at the same time, whatever it works for you. So remember, for the stories, we need to do sport, default, and then set a title here. And in this case, I'm just going to set picture. And let me check how I did it for the car, just to make sure. Yeah. In fact, we can also copy this as a template, because at the end it's going to be exactly the same. The only difference is I'm not going to use this list template, but let's just copy, because then we can save time. So, of course, instead of car, it's just going to be picture. I'm not going to use any child at all, so this can be gone. And also the archetypes, I'm just going to define a different one. One thing that I'm missing here is instead of car, it's a picture component, so let's just import the picture. And remember that also we want the styles, right? As we did it in the story, we got the car and we got the styles from the CSS module. So here I'm just going to do exactly the same. And then I'm just going to take the styles from our picture CSS module. So then we can create the proper template for this. And we are almost done. We are almost done. And of course, we need this get template, right? We need this helper. So if we go get template, here we go. It's on the helpers. And so for the arguments, I'm just going to set a default picture. And in this case, I'm just going to copy a URL that I have here. And this URL is just a placeholder. This pixun.photos is a service where you can just set different values, and you can set the width and the height, and it will just return a photo. This is just for demonstrative purposes. And then the width by default is going to be 200, okay? And for the archetypes, I want to be able to manage the width and the height just so I can play with those. So in that case, I'm just going to write the height here. And here, this is going to be control, and this control is going to be called a number. Storybook is going to paint a control that has a slide that has a number. So we will see in a minute how this looks. And then we are ready to start writing our stories. It looks like a lot, but of course, when you have more and more stories, you can copy and paste, and it's going to be pretty easy. So by default, it's just going to be the template binding an empty object. So that creates a new context. So that's our default story, and we can take a look how it looks right now. Meanwhile, I can create the other story. So the other story is going to be called rounded. In that case, round the arcs is going to be is rounded true. So if we go to a storybook, I should be able in the sidebar here to see another story, and I can see the story. Let's check. Let's review the console so we can see if there is any error here. We have a few warnings, and we have this unexpected error here. It says a role while loading picture stories, car is not defined. Okay, so we have some kind of, so we have this typo here. So picture, we replace it here. So take into account that when your story is not loading, it's because you might have an error. So here, if we take a look now, I can see my picture, and I have two stories here. So I have the picture, that the default one, and I can see the rounded one. So as before, you can change here like different parameters. For instance, you can change the weight. Let's say it's 400, and you can see this is bigger. And also you can toggle if it's rounded. It's rounded true or false. And you can also can set a number for the height. So the height could be like 200. Also, I can see here the rounded story. So that's it for the picture component. One thing that we can also do is create more stories. So as you notice, we are only having a second state that is basically the is rounded option. What if we just create like other stories to see how it looks with the width and with the height properties? So what I can do is copy this real quick twice. And then instead of rounded, my first story is going to be height. And instead of rounded in the second, copy and paste, is going to be width. So here I'm going to set a height, and here I'm going to set a width. And I'm going just to put a few numbers. So I'm going to put here, maybe this is going to be 400, and maybe this is going to be 400. And another thing that I could do as well it set different sources. So the fact that you have a default source here in the arguments, it doesn't mean that you can just change it of your convenience, right? So I can pass like this source here and this source here. And instead of be like 400, it can be 400, 800. And I can do a similar thing here. I can just revert that. And then I have a proper picture, not a pixelate or like enlarged picture that looks really weird. So here we can see different examples of how this will look if I use the height and how it will look if I use the width here. That's basically it with the picture, because we already have so many utilities like the game template and the get the styles. It's pretty easy just to use those different helpers and create multiple stories. So in our next lesson, we are going to see how we can create an avatar component in a storybook. See you in the next one.